In the last movie, you used a Revit preset for a daytime scene and learned to improve on it. In this movie, you do the same with the nighttime setup. Reset 3ds Max. Use File Link to link the FBX file you saved for nighttime purposes. You can also use the provided file named Room Night FBX. Make sure you use the Combine by Family type as you have learned. As you can see, even for a night scene, a daylight system is still getting imported, prompting you to use exposure control. As mentioned in the last movie, exposure control is needed to compensate for the brightness of the sun, much like on a real-world camera. An EV default value of 15 works for daytime, though, so you most certainly need to adjust that in a moment. Click Yes to proceed. Once the scene is loaded, you'll need to do a few actions similar to what you did in the last movie. First, click an empty spot to ensure all objects are deselected. Also, make sure the viewport is in realistic mode and set to be lit with scene lights. This will make the viewport temporarily dark, which is expected for a night scene. Also, hide the curtain wall. And set the rendering resolution to HDTV. For good measure, disable adaptive degradation as well. Zoom back and take a look at the scene. In an opposite situation to the last movie and the daytime scene, this time around, the artificial lights are enabled. The daylight system, on the other hand, shows the sun component in black, which is an indication it is disabled. Sure enough, this can be confirmed in the modified panel. In the motion panel, on the other hand, you can see the time of day set to 2200 or 10 p.m. as defined in Revit. This also accounts for the fact the viewport is dark, but it also has to do with exposure control. More on that in a moment. For now, press C to set the view to display the camera and test render the scene again. It doesn't look like much at all. Certainly not like a night scene you'd expect. There are a couple of reasons for that. Right now, only the artificial lights are barely showing. This is because currently, the EV value is still set to the default 15 value, which is more of a daytime setting. Go to the Environment dialog and set the EV value to 3 or 3.5. You'll notice an immediate change in the viewport shading, one that's more consistent with the current lighting scenario. Test render again. Well, the lights certainly look better, but the background doesn't work too well for a nighttime render. As mentioned in the last movie, the daylight system relies on three components: a sunlight as a direct light, a skylight to simulate the atmosphere, and an MR physical sky map for a background. Unfortunately, Revit presets only take care of enabling or disabling the sun direct light, so it is up to you to adjust the other two components manually. Disable the background and try again. It's better, but still too bright for a night scene. The overall brightness, especially outside, is happening because of the skylight system, even though it is 10 p.m. Disable the skylight and try again. In effect, anything related to the daylight system is now disabled. You are now relying only on artificial lights, and the render shows that. This looks much closer to what a night scene should look like. Ultimately, you can add exterior artificial lights and perhaps even a night background image, but I won't be getting into that right now. One important point remains: you have learned that at all times, Revit exports a daylight system along with the FBX file. But what if you are linking your Revit model to a scene that already has a daylight system, one that you have already set up to your liking? The answer to that is to create a custom import preset, so that when you link the FBX file, you specifically bypass the Revit daylight system. This is what you do in the next movie.